Assalamu alaikum students, my name is Ms. Pakiza and I am your maths teacher. Today we will learn that how to solve word problems. So students, first of all open page number 10, word problem number 1. Before starting word problem, I will tell you some keywords which are very helpful while solving word problems. So here you can see that 7 keywords are given. They are total, altogether, join, both, how many in all, sum, plus, combine, increase, together and add. So students, you need to learn all these keywords verbally because they will be very helpful while solving word problems. Because if any of them will come at the end of your word problem, you would easily recognize that which operation you have to apply, either addition, subtraction, multiplication or division. So students, all these keywords are given for addition word problems. Now we have to read our word problem number 1. That is, a factory made 64,750 jute bags on Monday and 51,060 more on Tuesday. How many bags were made altogether? So students, as you can see that the word keyword altogether is used at the end of the sentence. So here you can easily recognize that this is the operation of addition, because the keyword is altogether is used here at the end of the sentence. So we can easily understand that we have to apply the operation of addition here. So student, let's move to the cube activity. Through the cube activity, students, we can solve our word problem very easily. First of all, C stands for circle the numbers. So we have circled the numbers. The numbers which are 64,750 and second number is 51,060. After that, next step, underline the question. U stands for underline the question. As you can see that question is starting from how many bags were made altogether. So students, the whole question will be underlined. It is starting from how many and it is ending till altogether. So the whole question will be underlined. Next step, we have to box the keywords. Now B stands for box the keywords. The keywords which have already discussed in the beginning that they are very helpful while solving the word problems and through which we can easily recognize that which operation we have to apply. So here students, you can see altogether, the keyword altogether is already circled. So it means that we came to know that which operation we have to apply. Now in the next step, E stands for evaluate. Now we have to evaluate that which operation can be applied after finding out the keyword. So we came to know that we have to apply the operation of addition. So students, after that you have to come to the S stands for solve and check. So here we have to solve and check that whether our question is correct or not. So students, we are going to solve our question, that is solution. Now students, first of all, before solution, we must have to write the place value at the top. And our place value always starts from the right hand side. U stands for unit. Next is T stands for tens. Next is H stands for 100. Next is TH stands for 1000. Next is TTH stands for 10,000. Next is HTH stands for 100,000. So first of all, we have to write the place value at the top. So student, we have to write the First statement, that is bags made on Monday. Bags made on Monday were how many bags? 64,750. So we have written the value, and we will start writing the values from the right hand side. That is under Z, under a unit, we will start writing. We will be start writing from under unit 0, 5, 7, 4, 6. Then we will write the next statement. Bags made on Monday. Next statement is 51,060. Now again we will start writing this statement from the right hand side. 0 will come under unit, 6 will come under tens, 0 will come under H, 100, and 1 will come under 1000, and 5 will come under TTH. Next is bags made all together. So